What if I told you there is a new painkiller that works like an opioid but without any effect in the brain, without sedation or constipation? I'm Dr. Andrea Furlan, and today we'll talk about a groundbreaking new non-opioid painkiller just approved in the United States by the FDA. So let's talk about Suzetrigine today. What is Suzetrigine? Suzetrigine is the drug name, the brand name is Jurnavix. It's a first-in-class sodium V1.8 sodium channel blocker. That means it targets pain signals right at the peripheral nerve, not in the brain. So it has no central nerve system effects, like euphoria, sedation, or respiratory depression. If there is a surgery or a trauma in the hand, for example, the receptors in the hand will detect abnormal danger signals. And these signals will travel via the peripheral nerves to reach the spinal cord. There, they will make a connection and transmit this dangerous information to the areas of the brainstem and the thalamus in the brain. And then from there, the whole brain is informed of the danger in the hand. This is how acute, nociceptive pain works, like a surgery, an inflammation, or a trauma. Suzetrigine acts in the sodium channels NaV1.8, blocking them. These sodium channels are found in the dorsal root ganglia, or DRG. So suzetrigine has an effect to block the pain signals before the pain signals enter the nervous system. Contrary to opioids, which enter the nervous system and activate mu, delta, and kappa receptors in many parts of the spinal cord and the brain. Once these receptors are activated, those neurons are not able to transmit danger signals, and that's how opioids act. So here, you see a big difference. Both suzetrigine and opioids are able to stop the neurons from transmitting danger signals to the brain. Suzetrigine blocks these neurons before they enter the central nerve system, and opioids block the pain signals inside the central nerve system. You notice that I use the word danger signals, not pain signals. And this is in purpose, because pain is what the brain interprets when it receives signals from the periphery. Pain is a product of the brain. Well, now that you know how suzetrigine works, you understand that it is only effective for cases of acute pain, like a surgery, a trauma, or an acute inflammation. We call this pain mechanism nociceptive pains, because they involve the activation of nociceptors. Once the pain becomes chronic, it is centralized. There is no more tissue injury. But the problem is that the danger signals persist in the central nerve system. Therefore, suzetrigine is not capable of helping to relieve chronic pain. The FDA approved it in January 2025 for moderate to severe acute pain in adults. Suzetrigine is approved for short-term acute pain. Think like surgical recovery after a trauma or an acute injury. It's not for chronic pain like fibromyalgia or nerve pain from sciatica. In fact, early trials for chronic pain conditions were unsuccessful. If you like this video so far, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications button so you can be alerted when I post new videos here. What is the dose of suzetrigine? The first dose is 100 milligrams by mouth on an empty stomach, either 1 hour before or 2 hours after eating. After that initial dose, the person continues taking 50 milligrams every 12 hours, and they should not use it for more than 14 days. There are some side effects. The most common are itching, muscle spasms, rash, and an increase in an enzyme in the blood called creatine kinase. But suzetrigine doesn't cause constipation, sedation, or respiratory depression like opioids, and no withdrawals or tolerance. But since this is a new drug, we don't have long duration studies, and therefore there might be other side effects that we don't know yet. The studies compared suzetrigine with other painkillers, compared with non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and SEDs, there were comparable effects in reducing pain intensity. There was no gastrointestinal bleeding, but it did not help with inflammation, like a swollen joint from a rheumatoid arthritis or gout. Compared to acetaminophen, also known as paracetamol or Tylenol, it was better for moderate to severe pain. And compared to opioids, it had similar pain relief for acute pain. Now, there are some populations that should avoid suzetrigine. People with reduced kidney or liver function, people who are taking medications that inhibit the enzyme CYP3A4, because this could lead to an increase in the side effects of suzetrigine. Women who are trying to get pregnant, because we still don't know if this drug causes any birth defect. Or women who are breastfeeding. And since these studies were done in younger adults, we don't know if the same precautions need to be taken for geriatric population. Well, it's not all perfect. It is very expensive, about $15 per pill. Well, if you compare with just $12, you can buy a whole box of acetaminophen or a whole box of ibuprofen. And remember, it's not for chronic pain. As I explained before, most cases of chronic pain are due to a centralized phenomenon. There is no electrical activity of the peripheral nerves carrying danger signals anymore. So suzetrigine will not show any effect. Suzetrigine is not a solution to all pains. It will not replace opioids overnight, especially after surgical pain. But it is a huge step in the right direction. A real option for patients who need pain relief without the risks of sedation and respiratory depression. Please remember, this video is not intended to provide you medical advice. Talk to your doctor about your pain. This video is only for educational purposes. And if while you're watching this video there is any emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. If you find this video helpful, please give it a like, subscribe for more tips on living well with chronic pain, and share it with someone who might benefit. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.